understand it. This is my sixth grade STEM fair project. I chose this topic to educate my peers on how dangerous drinking Listerine really is. My presentation is called Listerine, Think Before You Drink. There's a popular YouTube challenge called the Listerine Challenge. In this challenge, you drink a bottle of Listerine. Seems harmless, right? Wrong. When you drink a bottle of Listerine, yes, you can get drunk, but the other active ingredients will make you extremely ill. Listerine dates back to 1879, where it was used as a surgical antiseptic, and then it became a cure for a disease that really wasn't a disease, halitosis. Halitosis was just the medical term for bad breath. Scientist George Lambert first coined the term halitosis. He used the word halitus, which in Latin means breath, and he took a medical term, osis, which means a condition of, and created the word halitosis. Really, all this means is you have bad breaths, and you need to take care of that. But people took this very seriously. The people who had been diagnosed with halitosis went and bought more Listerine. Who made Listerine, you ask? Joseph Lister did. He was the first person to ever carry out a surgery using Listerine as a surgical antiseptic. Yes, that is correct. The Listerine you know today wasn't always this way. Listerine was created about 133 years ago, used not only as that surgical antiseptic, but as floor cleaner and later a mouthwash. It was also a cure for gonorrhea. Don't try that at home. You see, there's all the information on the product. Now here's what happens when you drink it. Do not drink Listerine under any circumstances whatsoever. Now don't freak out if you swallow a little bit while using it, but if you drink excessive amounts of it, you will get extremely ill. If you drink a lot of Listerine, it very well may put you into a dangerous illness called metabolic acidosis. And that brings us into our next topic, metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis is a condition of too much acid in the body that, if left untreated, can quickly become life-threatening or often fatal. Our blood has to keep a balance of acid and base, which in the blood is called a pH. Blood pH is close to water. When we get sick or something makes our pH low, acidosis happens. Metabolic acidosis will then cause vomiting, chest pain, trouble breathing, coma, and our organs to fail, leading to death. One of the dangerous ingredients is a chemical compound which our bodies turn into salicylic acid, just like aspirin. Salicylic acid overdoses are very dangerous and cause things like vomiting blood, seizures, kidney failure, coma, and even respiratory arrest. Also, aspirin can give kids Reye syndrome, which can cause brain swelling and death. Listerine also contains chemicals called phenolic compounds like menthol, thymol, and eucalyptol. When you think about drinking it, just remind yourself that these ingredients are in other things such as Icy Hot, bug spray, vapor rub, and cigarettes. In conclusion, I hope you took this article to use to, one, not do stupid things like this, and two, to educate others to not do stupid things like this. Don't use Listerine as a substitute for alcohol. If you have an alcohol addiction, please get help. Nobody wants to see anything bad happen to you. And if you're too young to drink, then just don't.